remarquables et porcelainettes, les géniaux new-yorkais d'Helmet, ça n'existe pas. Page Hamilton et les siens ont sorti hier leur meilleur album à ce jour, Aftertaste, une performance d'une puissance inouïe qui justifie de nouveau la détermination dont ils ont toujours fait preuve.
The Melvins and the Jesus Lizard and Bark Market Dave's band. These bands we feel, very much a kinship with because we got in vans and drove around the country with them before Nevermind. We started out paying for our own recordings on Amphetamine Reptile and that's what indie, being on an indie label is about. And you get in a van, you go play shows, you make some money, you sell some records, maybe you make some money, generally not.
Du côté d'Helmet, le groupe a récemment lourdé son guitariste, Rob Echeverria, qui a illico rejoint Biohazard et a été remplacé tout aussi illico par Chris Traynor.
He had been in the band for 3 years, and we have a great personal relationship with Rob. We really get along great with him. We're still, on good terms with him. We've spoken with him, and it was a very hard decision, but we felt that we had kind of come to a point where musically it wasn't really meshing and developing into something.
There's a lot of things to learn, but so far this is like the dating period. It's been 6 months, so everything's great. It's like
good conversation. We haven't run out of things to talk about yet.
So everyone.
We haven't gotten into the responsibility part of the relationship yet. So
we haven't gotten into the commitment part.
Yeah.
You know how to live, and your high's gone by. Substance rush. Give an hour to try. You ratchet squat. A bent burn to the ground. Pass the buck. I never utter a sound. High times. Downtown. Julie Brown. High times. Hard times. You turned out. Wasted time. He escaped me.
this trend to that trend doesn't really matter. When we started out, Skid Row was huge, and Poison and Winger weren't, and nothing against those bands, that was their thing, you know what I mean? We wanted to do something different than that, and we're still kind of doing what we started out doing, but developing along our path. So how can we be influenced by you know, Dirty Riff jeans and, you know, Beads or the revival of 70s fashion?